Now I just want to tell you a short little story. Zusha's name comes from way back. He's not the first one that had that name. His name left the great tzaddik, Reb Zusha. He was called the Rebbe of Zisha. That was his real name. He used to call him. I just want to tell you a short story about the great tzaddik of Zusha. And that is that a person many years ago, he had a nice life, but like everybody else, he had some problems. And he couldn't seem to solve those problems. And he wasn't happy. He couldn't get over those problems. And he asked around, what's the best way to solve those problems? And the advice that he got was to go travel, to go see this great tzaddik of Zusha. And so he made it his business to go find the Rebbe of Zisha. And they lived in a small town. And he asked around where to go. And they gave him directions. They pointed out his house. His house, the door was on one hinge. He walked in, he knocked on the door. He came inside, he looked around. There was water dripping from the ceiling. The great tzaddik himself, his clothing wasn't, he was not a rich man at all. He wasn't healthy either. He looked around the room. He did a lot of painting. The chairs, he didn't really sit right. The table wasn't, he looks around the room, and the Rebbe and the tzaddik of Zusha looks at him, gives him a smile, and realizes, yes, he came to the right place. This great tzaddik, how happy he is. He came to the right place. He knows how to solve all my problems. And he started speaking to the tzaddik, and he told him, listen, I came here, I traveled all the way here, because they say you're the one who can help me solve my problems. And he started to explain to the tzaddik his different problems, and of course the tzaddik heard it, it bothered him. And after he gave up all those problems, he asked the tzaddik, can you please tell me how to solve my problems? And the tzaddik looks at him, and the looks at him, and he says, well, I'm sorry, I can't help you. And of course the man looks up, and why not? Why can't you help me? And the tzaddik says, listen, I in my life never had a problem. I can't solve a problem. I never had a problem. I'm not accustomed to that. I have no experience in solving problems, because I never had a problem. And this person looks around the room, and he thinks to himself, can you please tell me which problem you don't have? The furniture, the clothing, the way you're not healthy, what? Which problem are you missing? And he looks at the tzaddik, and the tzaddik repeats himself and he says again, I don't have any problems. I never solved the problems, I never had a problem. And the person doesn't know exactly what to do, all his hope is lost. And suddenly he realizes what's going on. This great tzaddik of Zusha, of course he had many problems, but he realized all the great things that Hashem gave him, this, and he realizes all the problems, and you might think of problems as a reason to everything, and he didn't see it as problems, he saw it all as something that's being done the right way. Sometimes you don't understand it, but it's being done the right way, and he believed in Hashem, God, whatever he does is right, and there are not problems that need to be solved, there's nothing wrong in the first place, whatever God does is perfect and it's great. And he looked around the room one more time and he got the message, and he left. Although it was a short meeting, just for a few moments, he took the message with him for life. Whatever Hashem does is perfect. They're not problems that need to be solved, but they're beautiful acts that Hashem does to help us out. And so Zusha here today carries a great name. A great, great name. And we hope, and we doubt, that Zusha will live up to that great name. And together, all of us together, we will share many, many more happy times, many more simchas together. Everybody here, I shouldn't say everybody, most of us here already had the Umbar Mitzvah. They know how exciting it is. And we're all excited for Zusha here today. Mazel Tov. And Mazel Tov, Zusha, Mazel Tov. Boys, I'm going to ask everybody here. And Zusha is going to say a small speech for us. I would ask everybody to please be quiet. Again, most of the, not everybody here is bar mitzvah, you know how it is, but you're bar mitzvah and practice and you want to be heard and you want people to be quiet and give your attention. So let's just sit quiet for a few moments.
The Torah in this week's portion tells us, Hashem told Moshe to come and accept the Rufus, the two tablets that the commandments are written on. But Moshe first built the Aron, the box to place the Luchos, and only God had not to accept the Luchos. But Moshe first built the Aron, a box to place the Luchos, and only then he went to accept the Luchos. We see from here a tremendous concept. In order to accept the Torah, a person must first have a place to store the Torah. Therefore, a person needs to make himself fit and worthy to have the Torah. Only then can he accept this precious gift, the Torah. Today is my Bar Mitzvah, and it is my day that I become one of those that have the great privilege of learning and keeping the Torah. I hope and pray that Hashem helps me lead my life in a way that is worthy of this tremendous task. And I always have the great honor of learning, keeping, and following in the ways of the Torah. I want to thank everyone here for joining in my Bar Mitzvah celebration. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Rabbi Erwin, Rabbi Finkelman, and Rabbi Reifman, and everybody else.
Thank you very much. Beautiful, beautiful speech. Singing title, Madam Pine, Hey, Lander, Lachal is going.